is me. On March 1st, 2017, at 7:28 p.m., my life changed forever. But let me take you back to the beginning. Severna Park, Maryland is the town that I grew up in. We have the record for the most field hockey state championships in the nation, and we have won the last three lacrosse state titles, but we are by no means known for our basketball abilities. This is our boys' team after they won their first game in over one full calendar year. I joined our high school basketball team during my sophomore year, and I was really bad. My best friend Claire was on the team, along with a young, tall, lanky prospect named Caroline Duffy, and a previous freshman phenom, Celeste Davis. Our friend Kat Ryan was on JV that year. Remember these four. They are important. Our sophomore season, we lost in the second round of the state playoffs to Arundel High School, and we were heartbroken. Fast forward to trads for our junior year, and we all had one goal in mind, to make it past the second round of playoffs. In summer league, I made a joke about what would happen if we played the best team in the county. You guessed it, Old Mill. Claire shrugged off that possibility, and we all pretty much knew that we would lose if we played them. We finished our junior season with a very modest 13-11 record. We entered the playoffs in the same bracket as the notorious Old Mill Patriots. Our opportunity was becoming a reality. Sure, we had a pretty rough regular season, but we thought that we had the right pieces to turn it on at the right time and maybe steal an upset against the notorious winners. Amazingly, don't ask me how, we jumped out to a 20-3 lead on Old Mill my junior year in playoffs. We headed into the locker room at halftime up 10, but Old Mill did what they do best and they just didn't go away. They chipped back all the way and made the game a tie going into overtime. And honest to God, nobody in the county thought that we would play Old Mill to overtime. Honest to God, I really didn't even think that we would make it to overtime with them that year. They were just so good and we were just so bad. And I know I said all that inspirational stuff earlier, but like seriously, nobody in the world thought that we would be in overtime with them at that point. But at that point, we weren't just happy to be there. We really wanted to come in and steal a win. Unfortunately, they ended up with one more basket than us, and we lost 53-51 to Old Mill in the state playoff second round on March 1st, 2016. Remember that date. It's an important date. Through the summer of 2016, going into our senior season, we had one goal in mind. We didn't care about getting to the third round of playoffs. We wanted to beat Old Mill at least one time. We became obsessed with it. We being the self-proclaimed Fab Five. There are five starting spots on a basketball court, and we had five returning seniors. And we had all the experience in the world behind us. Let me give you a rundown. At point guard, we have Celeste Chipotle Bowl Davis, the 4'11", fast as hell, shifty pest with the defensive ability to lock down any player in the state. I truly believe that. Celeste was the only member of the Fab Five who had played on varsity all 4 years of her career, which meant she had lost to Old Mill the most times out of all of us. Celeste could only have 4 points a game and still be the MVP with her defense and rebounding. At the shooting guard, we have Claire, short-tempered Domchick, a solid role player who does all of the little things very well and makes an occasional hype three-pointer. Claire has been my best friend since we were 5 years old, and being able to play one last season of basketball with her meant the world to me. We had won state championships in field hockey and lacrosse at this point, but nothing really mattered anymore as we, honest to God, really just wanted to beat Old Mill. And now, at small forward, we have Kat Human Sacrifice Ryan. I have no words to describe Kat's shooting ability, but what I can say is that she was the hardest working player I have ever been around in any sport. She was also able to guard pretty much anybody, which was helpful because there was only so much Celeste could do in the post, standing at a whopping 4'11". Kat was on JV as a sophomore, which is unrelated and unimportant, but Kat, I know you're watching this, and I just wanted to bring it up. At the power forward, we have
Caroline Duffy.
Caroline, what is it about the sport of basketball?
I think basketball, thing is, if you make Can I start over?
Caroline was able to hit a shot from anywhere on the court. Tall and lanky, but not to be messed with. Caroline Duffy could create a shot out of thin air by just chucking the ball in the air. And about 90% of the time, it ended up going in. Caroline was the best player in Anne Arundel County our senior year, and we all knew that. Caroline was also a member of the most epic dynamic duo in Anne Arundel County women's basketball history, which leads us in to the final member of the starting five, Katie DeFeo. You guessed it. I played inside while Caroline Duffy played the high post, and we were the most unstoppable force in the entirety of Anne Arundel County. I ended up actually getting first team all county in basketball with zero skills in the sport, only because I had Caroline as my shooter. I like to think of myself as the emotional leader of the team. I tended to engage in trash talk. It was a war for us every night on the court, and I wanted to make sure that everybody knew that. I thought of myself as the Kevin Garnett of the team. And last thing before we get going into the season, our coach Leo Latonic is a 60-something, brilliant basketball mine who graduated from the Naval Academy way back in the day. He has a big time day job, but he dedicated his nights to helping us achieve our one goal, turning a group of 5 seniors into the team that could beat Old Mill. Season started and we absolutely rolled through the county. Remember that team Arundel that knocked us out of playoffs my sophomore year? We beat them by 30 in the opening game and I got a technical foul for flexing in a girl's face. We were having a ball. We lost by single digits to last year's state championship team. We won the Christmas tournament and we absolutely manhandled our private school opponents. That was all nice, but there was one thing still on our mind. Old Mill. We didn't care about any of the things I just listed. We literally only wanted to avenge last year's playoff loss. On February 14th, 2017, we had our first chance. I'm not gonna bore you, we lost the game. Not by a lot, but we still lost. We finished out the regular season and then we played Old Mill again on February 21st, 1 week later, in the county championship. In Anne Arundel County, the county championship is completely separate from the playoffs. It has no implications on the state playoffs at all. It's just like a fun little throw-in game, but to us, it was just a second chance to beat Old Mill. We thought we had a chance in this one, particularly since we lost to Old Mill by 9 the first time, and we felt like we had used the week productively to prepare. This game was so much fun, we had a student section, and we were winning until the end of the third quarter. Then again, Old Mill did what they do best, and they came all the way back with an explosive third quarter. Wait, but look at this shot by me. I just wanted to draw some attention to this. Look at this. Yeah, watch it again. Yeah. I don't know. Anyways, we were down, but then we clawed back to force it to overtime, and then we ultimately ended up losing in overtime. Now moving into the state playoffs, we both had an easy first round game, and we both knew that we'd be playing in the second round 1 week later. But we only knew that it would take a perfect game to get the win. Okay, so this video might seem like it's dragging out, but I promise this is actually the good part. It is March 1st, 2017, and the objective is simple. The last time that Old Mill had lost a game in our county was February 2014. Look at this picture of me from February 2014. Exactly. Before the game, we were sitting in the locker room so nervous and nobody was talking. I wasn't even talking, one of the very rare times in my life, as many of you know. But then, like a sudden gust of wind, Layla Phillip, the mother of local legend Cullen Joyce, burst into the locker room and gave us a pregame hype speech. The story behind that is all year long, she would make game day Facebook videos and give us a song to listen to. It was really good luck throughout the whole season and she actually started a hashtag Mama Believes, but it definitely helped that she was in our locker room. So let me refresh you, the Fab Five, all together for 3 years in one last game with a fifth chance to achieve our longtime goal of beating these girls. If we lost, it was all over. All the fun times, all the jokes, the messing with our coach, all gone. It was our third time playing this team in 3 weeks, and we had originally made a goal of getting past this round in the playoffs, so a lot was on the line. We got off to a miserable start. We were down by 7 at halftime. We were only gonna be down by 4, but one of Old Mill's girls decided to pull up from NBA range and hit this 3-pointer right before the buzzer at the half. Also random, but I was like vomiting the whole first half. I literally was just running off the court, throwing up, and then running back on, and one of our coaches, Mags, tried to tell me that I should probably just sit out, but I knew that nothing was getting in the way of us beating Old Mill, and I had to do whatever I had to do. So down 7 at the half, Caroline Duffy, you know, best player in the county, was having a pretty rough game. I think she had 0 points, so I went up to her and I said, "Do you want to lose? Do you want to lose, Caroline?" And I gave her a good pump-up speech, and she ended up snapping in the second half for 16 points. We clawed back from down 11 in the third quarter, and all of a sudden there was around 30 seconds left. Old Mill's point guard drove to the bucket, they were down by 3 at the time, and threw up a shot. We battled for a rebound, and Celeste, of all people, came out on top. She got fouled and made the first of 2 free throws, and the rest was history. And I was the first one to use hashtag We Beat Old Mill, by the way. Now I use We Beat Old Mill in my everyday life, honestly. It is in some ways who I am as a person. It is what defines me. It is literally the greatest accomplishment of my young life. In the movie Miracle, after the US beat the Soviets, they went on to win the gold medal, but it was actually the complete opposite for us. We got killed in the next round by like 25 to some amazing team. They had like an inflatable mascot and all the lights went off for intros. It was really, really insane. And Claire actually ended her basketball career on a technical foul for clapping in a girl's face, I guess, and yeah, it was really sad. Here's a picture of me looking really sad after that game. But honest to God, we didn't care. Like, after the game, we were smiling and still talking about beating Old Mill because it's been the greatest accomplishment of my entire life. Our goal was never to win a state title or move past the fourth round. Our goal was to beat Old Mill, and words can't even describe how happy I am that we were able to accomplish that.